Hello and welcome to Med for Care. I am Dr. Care, and today's topic will be anosmia, the loss of smell. Let's find out together what it is. Anosmia is the complete loss of smell, unlike hyposmia, which represents the partial loss of smell. Our sense of smell allows us to perceive odors, and this is important to avoid dangerous situations such as smoke or bad odor emanating from burning stoves or gas leaks. Bad smell is also the first sign of spoiled food. Beyond dangerous situations, the sense of smell contributes to the perception of the taste of food, stimulating the digestive glands. Anosmia makes food less pleasant, and there is the risk of a change in eating habits in relation to the change in taste. At the basis of the development of anosmia disorder, there may be various causes such as nasal inflammation, better known as colds and sinusitis, nasal problems such as nasal polyposis or deviation of the nasal septum. Aging can be another cause of anosmia. In fact, the sense of smell decreases with age, starting with a hyposmia, to reach a complete anosmia. Furthermore, even continuous and prolonged exposure to radiation or cigarette smoke can cause the development of anosmia. Anosmia can be temporary or definitive. It depends on the cause that produced it. Let us now see what causes this disorder. Temporary anosmias are due to temporary inflammation. When the latter disappears, the anosmia disorder also tends to regress until it disappears completely. This is a case of sinusitis due to seasonal allergies, a severe cold, situations in which there is material that occludes the nasal cavities and therefore prevents the proper functioning of the structures responsible for the perception of odors. On the other hand, definitive anosmias are due to unchangeable situations over time, such as nasal malformations, neoplasms, systemic diseases. In general, anosmia, especially if it is caused by situations such as rhinitis or sinusitis due to contingent situations such as colds or seasonal allergies, resolves on its own together with the rest of the symptoms. In these cases, short-term treatments with topical or systemic corticosteroids, or with topical nasal vasoconstrictor drugs, which have anti-inflammatory activity and reduced nasal congestion, are useful. There are two conditions that instead lead to an in-depth evaluation. The first is the sudden onset of symptoms, especially in the absence of nasal congestion. The second is the absence of improvement after a few days of conventional cold treatments. In these two conditions, it is advisable to make an otolaryngological specialist visit to investigate the problem. It may be necessary to take antibiotic therapy to remove the material that obstructs the nasal passages and prevent the problem from becoming chronic, or it is possible to verify that there are no further conditions that require further diagnostic. After a careful medical history, we move on to the physical examination, which is carried out with a particular device, the endoscope, then carrying out a nasal endoscopy to directly view the nasal structures, looking for signs of infection or inflammation or lesions or malformations. The subsequent evaluation involves imaging analysis with a prescription of a cranial CT scan, or if the anosmia appears to be neurosensory in nature, a cranial MRI. We are now at the end of today's video. We hope you enjoyed it. If you found it useful, please support us with a nice like and subscribe to the channel. See you soon in Med for Care!